Hello everyone, welcome to Unit 3. This is a continuation of my earlier video. Today I'll be discussing about the quartile deviation. Before doing the quartile deviation, let's understand what do you mean by quartile. Quartile is a measurement which is divide the data into four equal parts. So, you know, quartile means like 1/4. So when the entire data set is divided into four equal parts, we definitely have three quartiles. Quartile 1, quartile 2, and then quartile 3. Quartile 2 is nothing but our median, which is dividing the data into two equal parts. So there are two types of measurement for quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. Quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2, and coefficient of quartile deviation, which is actually a relative measures of dispersion, Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. It's a ratio of two items. Quartile deviation is an absolute measurement, which is having the unit, same unit like the unit of observations, whereas for coefficient of quartile deviation is a relative measurement where there is no unit. Let's understand this with an example. See, calculate quartile, quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviations from the following data. These are the data of few people whose weights are given in terms of kilogram. So how do you calculate the quartile? First, let's see how to calculate quartile. The first step is we have to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Normally, we prefer to do it in ascending order. In this particular data set, the data is already arranged from smaller to larger or in an ascending order. The step two is we have to find quartile 1, which is n plus 1 by 4th item. Now, in my earlier video, when I discussed about median, if you remember, I have discussed there are three types of data for which we will calculate all these types of measurement. One is single series of observation or single series of data. One is ungrouped frequency distribution, and one is grouped frequency distribution. In the later on in my subsequent video, I'll be discussing about how to calculate quartile and quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation for an ungrouped frequency distribution and for a grouped frequency distribution. For the time being, let's take a very simple set of observations where you can see there are 10 observations are given. Right, so Q1 is equals to n plus 1 by 4th item. Please remember, I'm seeing here the item. It's not quartile 1 is not equal to n plus 1 by 4. No. So n plus 1, n is here 10 observations. So n is 10 plus 1 by 4th item. That means 2.75th item. Since we have arranged the data, we have to see the second item. And 0.75 portions of the difference between the third and the second item. That means second item is our 60 plus 0.75 into third item minus second item, which is 61 minus 60. Therefore, after calculating, I am getting the value of quartile 1 as 60.75 kilogram. Similar way, let's find out the quartile 3. Quartile 3 is equals to 3 into n plus 1 by 4th item. Just to remind you, quartile 2 is median, which is n 2 into n plus 1 by 4. Actually, 2 and 4 cancel. So normally for median, we use n plus 1 by 12th item. So continuing, quartile 3 is equals to 3 into 10 plus 1 by 4th item. That means 8.25th item. That is equals to 8th item. In our case, the 8th item is 72. If you consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 is 72 plus 0.25 into ninth item minus the eighth item. So therefore, the value is coming 72.25 kilogram. So this is the second step where we have actually calculated the quartiles. Now we have to find the quartile deviation. Quartile deviation formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So I have subtracted 72.25 minus 60.75 divided by 2, and I have got it 5.75 kilogram. Once again, I am repeating here, quartile deviation is an absolute measure of dispersion. Therefore, it will have an unit. Whereas coefficient of quartile deviation, which is a ratio of two items, you see Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Therefore, 11.5 divided by Q3 plus Q1 is giving you 133, and we are getting the coefficient of quartile deviation is 0.0864. It is unitless. This is a relative measure of dispersion. Coefficient of quartile deviation will help you to compare again two data sets with different units. There is one more very important thing which we normally discuss, which is called IQR, interquartile range. Most of the time in statistics, we make something called box plot, and where we are actually trying to show you the IQR, which is the middle 50% data. Box plot is a type of plot which normally we use to find out the outliers of data. Probably in my next or a subsequent video, I'll be discussing a little bit on the how to find the outliers of a data. But for the time being, let's understand what do you mean by IQR. IQR or interquartile range is equals to Q3 minus Q1. So basically, it is the middle 50% data. Let's just understand this diagram where I have written, suppose this is my entire data set. So as I already told you, there are three quartiles which divide the data into four equal parts. Q1 is dividing the data into 25% and the rest as 75%. Q2, which is our median, which is dividing the data into two parts, 50% below, 50% above. Q3, which is dividing the data into again two parts, the first side is 75% and the second side is only 25%. So IQR actually representing your 50% of the data. To understand it better, again I have taken another example just to see the number, the series. Again, it is already arranged in ascending order to make it simple. So let's see how many observations are there. There are 11 observations are there. So how do we calculate the Q1? Q1 is equals to N plus 1 by 4th item. N is 11, so 11 plus 1 by 4th item is 3rd item, and which is coming here as 15. Similar way, Q3 is equals to 3 into N plus 1 by 4th item. Therefore, 3 into 11 plus 1 by 4th item, that means 9th item, which is in our case, if you calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is 9th item, this is our 35. So we got Q3 as 35 and Q1 is 15. Therefore, IQR or interquartile range is 35 minus 15, which is actually 20. So once again, I'm just reminding you, we have done three types of measurements here related to quartile. First is quartile deviation, then coefficient of quartile deviation, and interquartile range. Basically, interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1, and if we divide IQR divide by 2, which we will get it, quartile deviation, which is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So in my next video, I'll be discussing about the other types of data like group frequency distribution and ungrouped frequency distribution and how to calculate the quartiles. See you there.